Bonjour tout le monde. Before I begin, I want to address Hurricane Fiona. Our thoughts are with Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic as they deal with the aftermath. The storm is expected to make landfall in Atlantic Canada tomorrow morning and could have significant impacts right across the region, including in parts of eastern Quebec. Anyone in these regions should take proper precautions, monitor the latest weather alerts, and be sure to listen to local authorities. Minister Blair and our team of Atlantic MPs are in close touch with provincial counterparts. The federal government is mobilizing resources to support however needed. So please stay safe. It is a real pleasure and honor to welcome President Yoon to Canada today. We're honored that you've chosen to come to Canada for your first bilateral visit abroad. You and I had the chance to meet in NATO in June, further meet at Her Majesty's funeral, and most recently in the last days at the UN General Assembly. But today, we are further strengthening our relationship as two strong Pacific nations. On confronte tous actuellement de nombreuses crises mondiales. La guerre injustifiable de la Russie en Ukraine, l'inflation, les changements climatiques. Alors, c'est important de travailler avec nos partenaires à travers le monde. C'est ce qu'on a fait ensemble aux Nations Unies plus tôt cette semaine dans plusieurs différents événements, et c'est ce que le président Yoon et moi continuons de faire aujourd'hui. With global inflation making cost of living a struggle for families all over the world, it's more important than ever that we work together to grow the economy and create jobs, especially good middle-class jobs, including for women, young people, and immigrants. Canada and South Korea have strong trade ties, with now 7 years of free trade between our economies through the Canada-Korea Free Trade Agreement. This is creating opportunities for businesses on both sides of the Pacific. Both Canada and South Korea are focused on growing our economies in ways that benefit everyone. Le Canada et la Corée du Sud travaillent ensemble pour créer de bons emplois et une croissance propre. Le Canada est bien placé pour être un fournisseur mondial d'énergie propre durant notre transition vers un monde carboneutre. Aujourd'hui, le président Yoon et moi avons discuté de moyens de collaborer dans divers domaines. Je pense aux minéraux essentiels, aux batteries pour véhicules électriques et aux technologies émergentes, incluant l'intelligence artificielle. Et dans ce domaine, on constate déjà des bons résultats. Par exemple, plus tôt cette année, notre gouvernement a investi dans un projet historique entre Stellantis et la société sud-coréenne LG Energy Solution pour construire la première installation de fabrication à grande échelle de batteries pour véhicules électriques au Canada. Together, we can create even more opportunities like this, including for Canadian resource workers, auto workers, innovators, and more. Canada and South Korea both have robust innovation ecosystems with strong research and post-secondary ties. We discussed ways that we can collaborate further on the responsible development of artificial intelligence technologies. Collaboration in these entrepreneurial, high-tech, and high-growth sectors will boost Canada's competitive advantage and attract good-paying jobs while it benefits people on both sides of the Pacific. Of course, President Yoon and I also discussed the situation in Ukraine. As two democracies, we firmly condemn Russia's irresponsible and dangerous escalation of its illegal invasion. Les démocraties du monde entier continuent de tenir tête au président Poutine. On est unis dans notre défense de l'ordre international fondé sur des règles. On Monday, as part of our commitment to upholding peace and the rule of law, Canada deployed the naval ship HMCS Vancouver to begin Operation Neon. This deployment will monitor the UN Security Council sanctions designed to pressure North Korea to abandon its weapons of mass destruction program. At a time of growing conflict and uncertainty, we must remain steadfast in our commitment to nuclear deterrence in the Korean Peninsula and around the world. President Yoon, my friend, the friendship between our countries is a special friendship, forged decades ago through war and continuously upheld by our commitment to peace, stability, and prosperity. 26,000 Canadians served in the Korean War, and we are grateful for the honor you paid these brave service members in the laying of a wreath at the National War Memorial earlier today. Thank you for that. We also have deep people-to-people ties with over 200,000 Canadians sharing Korean origins. The Korean community is an essential part of the Canadian family. We witnessed this as 8,000 people gathered to mourn the loss of Toronto Police Constable Andrew Hong at his funeral on Wednesday. L'année prochaine va marquer le 60e anniversaire de l'établissement de liens diplomatiques entre le Canada et la Corée du Sud. Je sais que nos deux pays vont continuer de travailler ensemble pendant de nombreuses années pour défendre la démocratie et la primauté du droit dans la région Indo-Pacifique et à travers le monde et pour créer des emplois et bâtir des économies qui fonctionnent pour tous. Thank you, my friends. Merci, mes amis. Comme ça, Hamnida.